Hi, in this lesson, we're going to talk about Fundraise's tasks. With Fundraise's tasks, you can create automated workflows that assign tasks to yourself or members of your team based on donation details. As an example, your team might write personal thank you notes for donations over $100. With Fundraise's tasks, you can automate a new assigned task for each donation over $100 and check it off when complete. Fundraise's tasks enable your team to work more efficiently and foster better relationships through timely donor touchpoints. Today, we'll cover a tour of tasks, creating a task automation, viewing tasks on a supporter profile, and task notifications. All right, let's jump in. You can find tasks in the side menu. When you open tasks, you'll land on a page that displays tasks that are assigned to you. This is your to-do list. By default, tasks are grouped by the automation that created them, but you can also sort your tasks by date. Each task row has helpful information and actions. From the response column, you can see the response this task requires, and you can mark this task as complete. You can click to open the supporter's profile to learn more about their relationship with your organization before responding. The amount is the amount of the transaction that created the task. Tasks are created based on transactions, so a transaction will always be associated with a task. This will make some more sense when we create a task automation in just a moment. You'll see the date this task was created, and you can also reassign this task if needed. To delete a task, click the trash can icon. Access all of your live automations by clicking Automation in the section header. Here, you can view the automation name, task type, and number of open and complete tasks, and even the average response time. Click the Actions button to edit or delete an automation. On the search page, you can filter through all tasks. For example, if you've completed your tasks early and want to help a teammate complete theirs, filter for tasks assigned to, equals, and select a team member. Then add another filter for status, equals, pending. This will display your team members' open tasks. And of course, you can create a new task automation from the section header. Let's create an automation to see how it works. Clicking the New Task Automation button will open an automation settings profile. Here's where you define the settings and the automation rules. Let's start with the settings. For the automation name, we recommend using a clear description of the automation rule. For example, donations over $500. Select the member of your team who should be assigned to complete these tasks. Select the type of response this automation requires. Selecting a task color is helpful if your team members are assigned to multiple task automations. Entering a note will help team members understand any specific details about a task. And finally, here are two very helpful workflow features. First, you can assign or reassign a supporter if they make a donation that matches your automation rules. You might use this if you want to assign a supporter to your development director when they make a donation of $1,000 or more. Second, you can create a supporter interaction when the task is completed. In most cases, we recommend checking this option so that your team has a history of each interaction with a supporter. We'll talk more about how task and supporter interactions work together later in this lesson. After you've configured settings, click Automation in the flyout side menu. Here's where you'll build the rules for this automation. An automation is based on transaction activity. This means that when a transaction is created and meets the parameters that you've set here, a task will be created. For example, if we add a filter for amount is above or equal to 500, a task will be created for each donation over $500. We'll cover some more helpful task automations in another lesson. For now, we can just click Save. You should always run a quick test. In most cases, the easiest way to test your automation is to manually create an offline transaction. To do that, let's jump to transactions where we can create a quick transaction that's more than $500. After creating this test transaction, just navigate back to tasks to see that a new task has been created. Easy. Now that you know how to create task automations and manage individual tasks, let's look at other areas of Fundraise's platform that interacts with tasks. Tasks and supporter interactions are connected in a really logical way. A task is really a reminder to interact with a supporter about one of their donations. For example, open a supporter profile and navigate to interactions. You'll see the open tasks for this supporter above their historic interactions. If you've configured it with your automation, when you complete this task, it will appear as an interaction. Next, let's take a look at how you can receive notifications for new tasks assigned to you. While some nonprofiteers may prefer to just log in and see their task list each day, some want to be notified immediately when a specific donation happens. So there are a few ways you can be notified. First, you can receive an email notification for new tasks. To activate task notification emails, activate general email notifications from settings. Navigate to settings, and on your profile, you'll see the checkbox for email notifications. Make sure that's checked. The second way to receive notifications is through Fundraise's mobile app, available for both Android and iOS devices. With a mobile app, your team can be notified on the go with push notifications. You'll also be able to view and manage your tasks in the app. And that's all for today's lesson. In the next lesson, we'll build a few recommended automations to get you started. See you soon.